up until recently, it was sort of an open question: should large corporations, should even small corporations, care about what's happening in social media? And I think those days are clearly over. It's absolutely vital for any company that wants to sort of cultivate a good public image to not only, you know, deliver a good product and kind of fulfill their promises, but to pay attention to what people are saying online and to engage with critics and to respond quickly to those who disagree, and to do it with grace and respect and transparency, so, you know, and integrity, that you have to do it in your name and directly. And that having that kind of ability to engage your critics is a really important skill that used to be thought of maybe just as a kind of crisis communications skill, and now is really needs to be an integrated part of how companies talk to the world. And then I think there's a second tier of how companies can use social media, which is a little bit less sort of high touch and one-on-one communication, but is about trying to synthesize vast quantities of commentary and, you know, sort of tweets and sort of real-time information to distill almost like real-time public opinion. So, for example, I worked on a study where we looked at, can you predict how a movie will do opening weekend based on data on Twitter around its opening on Friday, right? So you get data on Friday, and then you see, will it improve or decline its revenues on Saturday? And we found you could use that information and make very good predictions if you did just a few simple things, looking at the sentiment, what were people saying, positive or negative things about the movie, and how many tweets were there. And that kind of synthesizing of, or aggregating of, large quantities of data, where you don't care really what any individual person is saying, but you care what is the overall sentiment, is going to be, I think, very useful for companies that are smart about trying to gauge essentially public opinion, much like a political candidate would do. And I think it's not surprising in some ways that a lot of the innovation in social media marketing has come from politics first and is then adapted later by the corporate world, whether you're talking about Howard Dean or John McCain or particularly Barack Obama.